Every time I have gotten a call, an email or a message that goes like this in my career, are you available, would you like to, can you photograph, ... I feel secretly thrilled. This time it happened to be Alan Parker. I'm one of the millions of adoring fans. I loved all his films, Bugsy Malone, Mississippi Burning, Midnight Express, Angel Heart, Fame, The Commitments, I'd seen them all. Yeah, I think I just might make myself available, thank you, Emma Boquette. I travelled to Lotts Road to his studio to meet the big man. Mostly, I recall a humble, sweet, helpful, quiet man. So when I saw the FT Weekend magazine strapline, I am argumentative, I think that may come from growing up in Islington, I was pretty surprised. A month or two later, and this was amazing serendipity, I was asked to photograph Michael Sarrazin for a magazine called Club Enologique. Michael happened to be Alan Parker's cinematographer on so many of his films. The feature was about Michael having branched out into winemaking in his birth country, New Zealand, and the creation of his brand, Sarrazin Estate, in the early 90s. This commission was hugely helpful because I could ask if Alan Parker might be up for doing an affinity shoot, given their long-standing collaboration. Luckily, he said yes, and this is what happened.
Do you know what I mean? In other words, if you get a print made by the photographer around the time... But you can order stuff now, like, whatever.
When I did Evita, Madonna, for my sort of end-of-picture present, she bought me an original Ouija print. And it arrived, and it was one made by Ouija, and it was kind of... It wasn't pristine at all. It was kind of a bit yellow.
40, 50 years old.
So she wouldn't send it back because it wasn't, in pristine. Perfect condition. But it actually looks quite beautiful because it's kind of crumpled and stuff, but made by him. There's very few of them. Robert Doisneau gave me his 6 pictures, and they're all signed to me. Right. Someone said they were really very, very valuable if they didn't have my name on it, and just his.
The thing we enjoyed about film probably most was a shared aesthetic and sense of humour, which was nice.
Really?
Yeah. The pressures are huge, more on you than me. But
why do you see? I don't like making movies anymore. You still do, don't you? Why do you think that is?
It's all I know how to do. No, I still enjoy it. I do.
You've got a bloody great vineyard. What are you talking about?
Yeah, but that's it's not the same. I don't grow the grapes and make the wine. I'm like the artist.
If you don't make a movie in a year, do you really, really miss it being on a film set?
Part of it is the film, but it's also it's part where you're living. If you're living and working in New York City, it's brilliant.
True.
Louisiana, San Francisco, all of them. If you're living in some motel on a freeway, upstate, wherever, where home is a motel room.
Jackson, Mississippi.
I didn't do that.
Also, I think, our generation were mostly in streets,
On location, as opposed to streets.
Whereas, Alfred Hitchcock used to get up in the morning, same time every day, go over the hill to the studio, do a day's work, finish at 5, come home, sleep in his own bed. Yeah. It's a different kind of life, really.
Well, that's where the word industry takes over from film.
Well,
studios, I think, is the industry.
It's actually infinitely more civilised, though, God, I remember how horrible that was, doing a huge dance number in the middle of 46th Street. You think, why did I put myself through that? I should have
because at the time, it was a challenge. And when you look back at it, maybe it's reanalyzing it. I just remember, this is what we got to do.
I remember them as 3 miserable days, though. I think, how am I going to get
Because of the stress.
The stress was just enormous, and you think, why do you do that? Why do you need to do that? I wrote the scene, and then and you're shooting it, you've caused complete, the police want to close you down, you cause a traffic jam as far as I can see, and everyone is like frazzled.
Yeah, but in the end,
frazzled. Does art have to be painful?
What I'm saying to you is I don't believe it was that painful. It wasn't painless, but I don't... We were young, we had huge energy, physical, mental, and all the others
as well. I just think, just doing painting on my own...
Yeah, but that's now.
It's just me, and it was not stressful in the slightest. Having to make art with 100 other people, that's the tough part.
Oh, she may be weary, and young girls, they do get weary.